The common problem on Creality printers is in the hot end. If you don't get that PTFE tube all the way down to the nozzle, you get a blockage or you get bad prints. I showed how to fix it on my CR10 Mini by replacing the coupling and new PTFE tube, but I found another way to fix it, and I'll show you what it is on today's Filament Friday. This episode of Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. So here's a 3D print of the CR10 hot end. It's got a coupling at the top, heat sink, and the PTFE tubing that comes all the way into the nozzle. But if there's any gap like here, that's where the problem is. You gotta make sure there's no gap. So if you look at other hot end designs, such as E30 V6, they'll typically have a little PTFE tube trapped inside the heat break. And then the Bowden tube comes in at the coupling and meets up with it. So that's what the idea is here. You cut a small piece of PTFE tube, put it in the hot end, put a little plastic washer, and then you put the coupling on to trap it between the coupling and the nozzle. That way it can never move, and they're always butted up against each other. No gaps. Here's a mock-up of the idea we're going to try in this video. Basically, we've got PTFE tubing coming into the coupling, a little spacer here, and then a section of PTFE tube that goes all the way down to the nozzle. Several people have commented on Filament Friday videos tipping me off to this idea, so I went to Thingiverse and I found it under the username OneBadMarine. And he's got full explanation, he's even got some gauges on where to cut the PTFE tubing. So I decided to try it out on this Ender 3. It's a base Ender 3, but it's got several mods that I've done. The EZR extruder, it's got the filament to the side, it's got a glass bed, so it's got a few other things that I've added that I've shown in videos previously. So it was the perfect candidate to try this out. And all it required was a small little plastic piece to go inside the hot end. I cut a piece of Capricorn tubing and shoved it down inside the heatsink and pushed it all the way down, almost to the nozzle. And then I put the washer, the plastic washer, on top of that and pushed. Now the plastic washer shouldn't melt because the top of the heatsink should stay cool. And then I put the coupling on top, and because my fat fingers would get in the way of the camera, I just use a wrench here to tighten it up. And then when it got close to tight, I just gave it one small turn. I didn't want to overclamp this and mess anything up. I already had one of the Daniel Norway's 3D benchies on my machine already sliced, so I printed that guy out and just watched for any gaps or flaws or this thing to come apart. And everything looked fine. This benchy was coming out really good. And when it was done, I took a closer look at it. I couldn't see anything wrong with it. So I decided to print a few more items in this to test it. Now this is my Filament Friday Filament PLA Orange. And I printed one benchy, two benchies, three more benchies, and they all look good. So then I tried some filament of wood filament. And this stuff printed beautifully. This is one of the better prints. So then I tried some metal flakes, some CHEP, Protopasta Candy Apple Red Metal Flake. Printed fine. No issues. And then I remembered I'd found this PC4M10 coupling that you could 3D print, and it had a grip so you could easily remove the PTFE tube or install it. So here's the pieces printed out. You have the coupling which will screw right into the heatsink, and the threads came out beautiful. I printed this on my Ender 3. And then you slide in the PTFE tube from the extruder, and it just pushes down in, very easy. And then you put the nut on, and it clamps down on this thing and pinches the PTFE tube, but you can always easily remove it. And it's tight. So I had a thought. What if I took this coupling, and then I added that washer inside, and together I made a custom coupling that had the spacer in place? So that's what I did. So here it is, mocked up. There's the PTFE tubing and my new coupling on top of it that would screw into place. And the PTFE tube is longer, so it's easier to get to, and then the top piece comes in and you clamp it down with that nut. I installed the 3D printed coupling on one of my CR10 minis that's in my print farm. This particular machine prints these little plugs for a customer. It runs 24/7, so I thought this is a great test of this coupling. And it seemed to be holding up, didn't seem to be moving at all. But when I came back, I saw this, it had popped out. And I thought, how did the threads fail? It seemed fine before, but when I touched the top of the heatsink, it was really, really hot. So it turns out it got hot enough to soften the PLA. And you can see here, it just pulled right out, flattened the threads. Well, it wasn't the coupling's fault. It's the fan. The fan on my CR10 Mini was barely spinning. You can see the blades here on the left. The replacement is the one on the right, spinning beautifully, blowing cool air. So I put that on a machine and it fixed the problem. The print quality of these little plugs has been fine. There's been no blockage in the hot end or nothing, but this plastic coupling found a problem I didn't even know I had. And no sensor would have caught that, like thermal runaway protection or anything, because the hot end was working fine. It just wasn't blowing enough air on the heat sink to keep it cool. And that's why the thread softened and popped out. So it's kind of a safety feature in a way, without really planning it that way. So anyway, I put the new fan on it. It's staying really cool. This thing ran for several days printing more of these plugs. It's been running great. I haven't had the thing loosen up. I check it from time to time. So this little plastic fitting seems to work just as good as the other one here. So this seems like a clever idea. It seems to work so far for me. And you can use a higher temperature like Capricorn tubing for this little section and still use the stock tubing, you know, back to the extruder. And so maybe you can get a little higher temperature printing that way. I don't know, maybe. Now for the washer, I didn't use his in my test. I actually designed one very similar in Tinkercad. I just wanted to try it and it seemed to work fine, but his should be fine as well. But I wanted that because then I brought that into the design here where I made this guy with the base of the washer inside of it. So that way I could control the size and everything that I had inside of here. So I'm going to share this coupling that I modified. I'll share this on Thingiverse. There'll be a link in the description below. I also modified the nut. I made it a little bit smaller because I noticed that it hit on the nut or the screw that's in the bracket right here in the CR10 Mini. So I made this a little bit smaller so it should be able to clear that screw, and it seemed to work pretty well. Plus, now because it's smaller, it sits a little higher. But man, this thing works great. It clamps down on that PTFE. Does a great job. So if you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of these videos that are popping up. If you want to help support the channel, Patreon's the way to do that. Or just use the affiliate links in the description below. That helps a ton. It really does. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.